I was watching TV for the debate, policy debate in the House last night. It was quite chaotic.
Yes, and that's a little bit of understatement. This is a big, big mess.
Yeah. Yes. Uh-huh. So who started the trouble?
Well, it depends on where you come from.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. To me, at least Khun Chuan get things a little bit heated up when he start talking about the Sultan, Thailand, the problems, and Khun Thaksin mistake.
Yes.
And then the situation seemed to getting a little bit heated
after that. Got a lot of protest from government MPs.
Yes.
Saying that Khun Chuan should not be referring to the past, he should talk about the future.
Yes.
And I suspect that every time there was a negative mention of Thaksin, the government MPs would stand up to protest. And that seemed to be the strategy from the government side.
Yes, and then House Speaker Somsak got himself involved in this by allegedly siding with the government MPs.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So that's why the protests come, you know, on and on.
Right.
Keep coming.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And then you have Khun Dipit,
the
Democrat MP who start talking about the controversial book publication of the Red Shirt Movement.
Red Power. I think it's a magazine, weekly magazine, and he said that this magazine was distributed in a meeting of the Pheu Thai Party. He was suggesting that the Red Shirt publication is part of the Pheu Thai Party activities.
Yes, and that's where I think Khun Chattopon and Khun Nattavut fell into the trap.
Yeah.
They start protesting, they start talking about the Red Shirt Movement, and
they
start talking about this one word, license to kill.
Oh, yeah.
Which lead to chaos, like you said.
Because when Khun Chuan spoke, after that Khun Nipit spoke, Khun Nipit was trying to emphasize that the Red Shirts and the Pheu Thai Party are together. This is a two-leg policy, two-prong strategy devised by Thaksin.
Yes.
And Nattavut and Chattopon stood up to protest and started to get very emotional about any mention of Red Shirts. And at one point, Nattavut, I think, said that the charge, Les Majesty charge, was being used by the previous government, the opposite government,
as the license.
As a license to kill.
To kill.
And that started the real trouble because
Khun Apisit and Khun Suthep, they took turn in protesting and a lot of protests.
Because
it took like a lot of time and forcing the House Speaker to suspend the debate.
Right. Because Khun Suthep insisted that the Les Majesty charge had nothing to do with the killing of 91 protesters.
Yes.
And that Khun Nattavut was trying to mix the two together and made it very libelous. Nattavut said, "I didn't say that." And Khun Suthep asked the speaker to get Khun Nattavut to withdraw the statement.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And he refused to withdraw the statement. And then Khun Apisit stood up to insist that the speaker must do something about it because Nattavut did say that. So the speaker, Khun Somsak, was sort of caught in the middle of it.
Right. And whenever people start talking about reconciliation, this kind of thing happened.
Yeah.
Every time. Actually, Khun Nipit was debating reconciliation plan of the government.
And at one point, there was no way that the House Speaker could really make the meeting continue peacefully. So he called a intermission.
Yes.
He said 10 minutes, but I counted, and it took about half an hour.
Half an hour.
And I think they went over to the tape to listen to what Nattavut actually said. And
he withdrew.
Yeah.
He agreed to withdraw his statement.
Yeah. And then, for some reason, there was about, I think, 11 o'clock.
11 o'clock.
At night. And one of the government MPs stood up and proposed that the policy debate be ended.
Yes.
And that started another big mess.
Yes. Uh-huh. It's supposed to be a quorum check.
Yeah.
And I think they did check the quorum and they don't have enough.
Because the Democrats, a lot of Democrat MPs
boycotted
the
one way or the other.
Yeah.
They just left the meeting hall or they just didn't use the card to register their participation.
Yeah.
Anyway, they didn't have the quorum to
so the speaker said, okay, we call the meeting off, we call it a day, and then that's it. But I think somehow he decided that, well, the meeting could not just be ended that way. So he decided to get his secretary to call all the MPs sending SMS messages?
That's not the problem. Because the rule required to give MPs and senators at least one day to prepare.
At least one day.
Yes.
But then, you know, the SMS messages were sent after midnight, and the meeting was supposed to take off this afternoon. So it was less than one day, and
technically it cannot be done.
But anyway, you know, it proceeded. The meeting was resumed this afternoon, and it ended with the Prime Minister, Khun Yingluck, giving a brief end of policy statement.
Closing statement, yes.
Which ended nicely. She said that, although, you know, I don't expect to get 100% in this test, in this exam, I'm sure I will pass every subject.
Yes. It's okay. It's a very good, touching closing statement by Khun Yingluck. But considering what happened last night, that's one of the a little bit of flaw on the government part last night.
Well, this is only the first parliamentary test for Khun Yingluck.
Yes.
There'll be many, many more to come. So the speaker and the government whips would have to work very, very hard from now on to make sure the Prime Minister is not caught in another mess.